After high school, did there come a time when you began working at the Bethlehem Steel Plant?
Yes.
And we'll say 1950 to 1983. Other than some temporary layoffs, did you work almost continuously at Bethlehem Steel?
Yes.
Can you tell us, what is the function of the mold yard? I mean, what was its function, specifically the one you worked at Bethlehem Steel?
Well, the hot tops we had to clean out.
What is a hot top?
It's an extension, actually, of the mold. As they pour the heat, all your slag and all the impurities would rise to the top, and it would go into the hot top.
Was anything inside these hot tops during
this? Oh, yeah.
And what was that, sir?
Well, the boards, the insulation boards.
What, if anything, was the function of these boards? I mean, do you know why they were being used?
Well, to keep the heat from destroying the hot top.
And what names, if any, did you personally see on these hot top packaging?
Well, there was Foseco and Ferro.
And just so we're clear, sir, could you spell Foseco for us?
F-O-S-E-C-O.
And the other one, how do you spell that?
F-E-R-R-O.
And, sir, can you tell the jury how the molds were actually cleaned out by you when you were a mold man?
They're cleaned out with a suction pipe run by air. And the pipe extended down into the mold. Now, there was a bottom to all the hot top molds. And if you couldn't see very well, you had a flashlight and you could make sure you got all the dust out. Well, they're very particular about their steel after a while. They didn't want any more impurities in there than they had to have.
And what would you see, sir, when you would personally use the air hose? What would you see as a result of
doing dusty, very dusty.
Would you see the dust with your own eyes?
Oh, yeah.
Would you breathe in that dust?
Probably.
And did you ever have to use a broom from 1972 to 1976?
We had to sweep.
But did you personally have to sweep?
Yes.
The sweeping, sir, did that... What did the atmosphere look like when the sweeping was being
very
performed?
Dirty.
Would you see the dust in the air?
Oh, yeah.
Would you breathe in that dust?
Yeah.
Could you please look at McDonald 3 and tell the jury, what is that a picture of?
That's a hot top on a mold.
And if you can, sir, would you use the pointer and in relation... If that's the hot top, where would the mold be?
Mold is right here. This is a hot top that's turned over in the rack. It's upside down. That's the only way you can get these boards in.
Now, we've been talking about insulating boards.
These insulating boards. These boards this board and this board would be on the side.
Okay.
These two boards would be on each end.
Okay, so you had a total of how many boards?
Four boards.
Did you ever see any warning labels concerning the hazards of asbestos on any of the hot top packaging?
No.
Focusing again on the hot top packaging, more specifically on Ferro, did you ever see any warnings on the Ferro packaging concerning the hazards of asbestos?
No.
Same question for Foseco. Did you ever see any warnings concerning the hazards of asbestos?
I don't think they ever had any warning on any of them.
Sir, while you were working at Bethlehem Steel from the late 40s to the early 1980s, did you ever know asbestos could injure you if you breathed it in?
No.
When did you first personally become aware that asbestos may be harmful to your health?
Well, just before the plant shut down. We didn't know that much about it. I think some of the people had x-rays. They found out they had asbestos.
Sir, if you knew that the materials you worked with throughout your career, like the hot tops, could cause cancer, would you have worked with any of these materials?
No.